top deadliest pandemics ravage mankind.
While the coronavirus outbreak in early 2020 is without a doubt one of the most serious international public health emergencies in recent memory, it is unlikely to come close to the devastation wrought by some of history's worst outbreaks. Let's take a look back through our history from the Pharaoh dynasty to the present day to see the top biggest outbreaks in the human race. 1. The Plague of Justinian. The Justinian Plague was one of the deadliest plagues in known history, with millions of fatalities. It began in Egypt in AD 541 and was carried to other continents by merchant ships infested with disease-carrying rodents. The cause of the disease was Yersinia pestis, a facultative anaerobic organism that can infect humans via the Oriental rat flea. It also led to the Black Death, which is estimated to have killed 30 to 60% of Europe's population from 1347 to 1351. According to the book Secret History, victims suffered from delusions, nightmares, fevers, and swellings in the groin, armpits, and behind their ears. Many victims suffered for days before death, while others died almost immediately after the onset of symptoms. It was so widespread that no one was safe. Even the emperor caught the disease, though he did not die. Dead bodies littered the streets of the capital. Justinian ordered troops to assist in the disposal of the dead. Once the graveyards and tombs were filled, burial pits and trenches were dug to handle the overflow. Bodies were disposed of in buildings, dumped into the sea, and placed on boats for burials at sea. And it was not just humans who were affected. Animals of all types, including cats and dogs, perished and required proper disposal. 2. The Flu Pandemic of 1918. The Spanish flu pandemic of 1918 infected an estimated 500 million people worldwide, about one-third of the planet's population, and killed an estimated 20 million to 50 million victims, including some 675,000 Americans. It was caused by an H1N1 virus with genes of avian origin, though it's unclear exactly where the virus originated. This virus contains the glycoproteins hemagglutinin and neuraminidase. Hemagglutinin causes red blood cells to clump together and binds the virus to the infected cell. Neuraminidase is a type of glucoside hydrolase enzyme, which helps to move the virus particles through the infected cell and assist in budding from the host cell. When an infected person sneezes or coughs, more than 500,000 virus particles can spread to those nearby. A unique feature of this pandemic was the high mortality in healthy people, including those in the 20 to 40 year age group. A large factor in the worldwide occurrence of this flu was increased travel. Modern transportation systems made it easier for travelers to spread the disease. But the flu threat suddenly disappeared in the summer of 1919, when most of the infected had either developed immunities or died. 3. Ebola virus. Compared to most illnesses, the Ebola virus is rarely transmissible. You can only get it from direct contact with the blood or bodily fluids of an infected person or animal, like a monkey, chimp, or fruit bat. Signs and symptoms typically start between 2 days and 3 weeks after contracting the virus, with a fever, sore throat, muscular pain, and headaches. Vomiting, diarrhea, and rash usually follow, along with decreased function of the liver and kidneys. At this time, some people begin to bleed both internally and externally. The disease has a high risk of death, killing 25 to 90% of those infected, with an average of about 50%. This is often due to coagulation abnormalities, including gastrointestinal bleeding, development of a rash, cytokine release, damage to the liver, and massive viremia, a large number of viruses in the blood, that leads to damaged vascular cells that form blood vessels. As the massive viremia continues, coagulation factors are compromised, and the microvascular endothelial cells are damaged or destroyed, resulting in diffuse bleeding internally and externally. This uncontrolled bleeding leads to blood and fluid loss and can cause hypotensive shock that causes death in many Ebola-infected patients. 4. HIV/AIDS. This is a pandemic we're still battling. Unlike other illnesses, this is followed by a prolonged period with no symptoms. However, around 80% of people may develop a set of flu-like symptoms known as acute retroviral syndrome around 2 to 6 weeks after the virus enters the body. Without medication, HIV attacks the body's immune system, specifically the CD4 cells, T cells, which help the immune system fight off infections. The person becomes vulnerable to serious illnesses. Over time, HIV can destroy so many of these cells that the body can't fight off infections and disease. This stage is known as AIDS. People with AIDS have an increased risk of developing various viral-induced cancers, including Kaposi's sarcoma, Burkitt's lymphoma, primary central nervous system lymphoma, and cervical cancer. According to 2019 global HIV and AIDS statistics, it's grown to pandemic proportions, with an estimated 74.9 million infections and 32 million deaths worldwide. We don't know how to cure it, but we can control it with proper medical care and prevent it by avoiding unprotected sex and not sharing needles. The good news is that most outbreaks listed here are rare in some cases and can be preventable. What we can do to protect ourselves from these diseases is to stay up to date with the news before traveling and get the latest flu vaccination. Healthy eating and staying away from animal products of unknown origin are also helpful tips that can prevent you and your family from contracting or transferring infections. And last but not least, if you suspect recent exposure to the virus, seek medical care early and share your previous travel history with your healthcare provider.